Brother George Jackson quotes Paul Laurence Dunbar and Claude McKay all the time, and no one has ever noticed. They're always in quotation marks, but not attributed in any other way. And so, but if you know Dunbar and you know McKay, you hear it throughout the letters. So, but next we have Kaleika Baruti, the executive director of the George Jackson University. Again, we flew here from Dallas with comrades just to be with us. We're very, very happy.
Very happy to be here with you all. I mean, coming from Dallas with my comrade Eric Caffre with Gorilla Mainframe, it means so much for us to be here. And each and every moment that I exist here with you all, it gets greater and greater. Sitting here on the panel with a number of women is a great thing. And getting to be sitting right under Rasmia is amazing for me. I understand solidarity. I understand the struggle for liberation and freedom. It is a necessity for us all. And I first became acquainted with George Jackson and the Son of Palestine through an internet outlet called the San Francisco Bay Muse. San Francisco Bay Muse have been a tremendous support system for men and women in prison, for organizers in the California area, for organizers internationally, for people who are fighting for that independence and liberation that they so rightfully shall have. And San Francisco Bay Muse have been a great advocate of George Jackson University, which I'll tell you more about. But I found out about the exhibit in the Bay View. And being a part of George Jackson University, it is our duty to carry forth his name, to carry forth his spirit. But when I seen the exhibit, I was floored because his name is being spoken in Palestine, and it meant so much for me. And I wanted to be a part of whatever was going on with that, but it was amazing to see it in such a great distance, George Jackson's name. So I contacted Grit immediately, and we made connections, and he came to George Jackson University radio show, and he told us all about it. And we vowed to keep in touch with each other. But I didn't realize that our in touch would be as soon as it was. And the exhibit came here thanks to Art Two Forces here to Oakland. And it allowed for us, George Jackson University, to be a part of this. And this is, it means a lot. George Jackson University was founded inside of Pelican Bay Shoe System. Pelican Bay, you may be familiar with the hunger strikes and so forth. There are a lot of what we call New African political prisoners that are in Pelican Bay. But recently, a lot have been moved to the main line because there are a lot of people like you all that advocate for treatment, just treatment of prisoners. You know, and there were a lot of things that are going on inside of the shoe system, inside of solitary confinement throughout the world that is totally inhumane. But people like you all make great contributions to change the conditions of those type of realities. So a lot of them have been moved to the main line. But our founder, Abdul Al-Azhar Shakur, he did 32 years in the shoe. He's still in prison now. He may never see the light of day. But he, as George Jackson, you know that, hey, I am not a dog, just like Claude McKay said, that we must die. You know, let us die, you know, standing, fighting back. And so there are men and women in prison who understand that. And a lot of their understanding comes from people like George Jackson. George Jackson, he created inside of the prison industrial slave complex, that we call it. He created a culture of resistance. He said in War Without Terms, he said, you know, I will come back to torture and torment
the monster that's inside me, the maker of this monster that has been engendered inside of me. They created this monster, and I would come back to torment my maker from the grave. And they, inside of Pelican Bay, and particularly all the prisons inside of California, they fear, they have a great fear for anything that has George's name attached to it. Oh boy, it is something else. And it is something that we have been battling for a long time, and we have been winning, and we have been resisting that. And so we carry George's name in a spirit by educating men and women inside of the prison to use that monster that has been engendered into them to serve their communities. The prison is designed to keep us away from one another. It is designed to keep the families at bay. It is designed to create animals. It is designed to not have us progress. It is the institution of this imperialist and capitalist state. It serves its purpose very well. However, we understand that there are things that we can do to transform that, to create men and women who are inside of those institutions that can make contributions to our realities as well as we can for them. We have political education with these men and women in prison. We are looking to build institutions in the name of George Jackson, so when they come out of these institutions, they can be of service in their communities or be wherever they're needed. And we do that through writings such as George's writings. We study everything that you can think of that's necessary to study to create an ideology where they have a loyalty, where they have a passion to do these things. And so the state repression, it is alive and well, but we continue to push forth. And inside of our communities, we use these types of avenues to connect with people who share the same interests, who want to be liberated, who want to see the people of Palestine free, and things of that nature to connect with. And we all have a responsibility to one another. We have a great responsibility. So George Jackson University, our goal is to reduce recidivism, keep them out of prison, by transforming the criminal mentality into a revolutionary mentality like the one that George Jackson possesses. So the monster that's engendered in him, which is a just monster, it will serve its purpose for humanity. And so George, his spirit dominates me. And there are, we have 280 students who carry that same spirit, and the fire shall grow. We want to create the army that George Jackson spoke of. We want to create the army that will be able to defend the people of Palestine. As long as they're fighting, we're fighting. As long as we're fighting, they're fighting. And we want collectively for people to understand it and to fight as well. So as long as there's breath in our bodies, we'll continue to fight, we'll continue to resist, and we do know that we will win.